वेलकम टू रैंसी इंजीनियरिंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन द फील्ड ऑफ रेफ्रिजरेशन एंड एयर कंडीशनिंग। इट इज़ द हार्ट ऑफ दिस फील्ड एंड इट इज़ द बेसिक, सो दिस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग एनी अदर स्टडीज। ऑल एयर कंडीशनिंग and refrigeration equipment, the working principle based on the refrigeration cycle or vapor compression refrigeration cycle. In this cycle we have four mechanical components. One is compressor, number two is condenser, number three is expansion or throttling valve, number four is evaporator. This cycle is start at the section of compressor where low pressure vapor enters the compressor, and the compressor compresses it to a very high pressure, increasing its temperature and pressure, and at the discharge line gives as a high pressure vapor. Then it go to the number two part, condenser. Condenser we can say are divided in two types. One is water cooled and another is air cooled. Water cooled condenser we use where the outside temperature we have very high outside temperature, and the air cooled temperature is can be used everywhere and it is compact. Air cooled compressor also are two types. For very small application we use the natural air like a refrigerator. In the condenser we have only coils and it is cooled by natural air, whereas for air conditioning, for air conditioner, for chiller we have the blower to transfer the heat, to blow the heat through the coils. Inside condenser the refrigerant enters as high pressure vapor and it gives out its heat to the surrounding and comes out as high pressure liquid. After condenser, the high pressure liquid refrigerant pass through the number three items, expansion valve or throttling valve, which reduces the pressure abruptly, causing the temperature to drop dramatically. So this high pressure liquid, when it passes through the expansion valve, it converts to a mixture of liquid plus vapor at low pressure. After this, the number four device component came of the refrigeration cycle, evaporator, and it is the purpose for what we are using this cycle. If we are using this cycle for the air conditioning, so it is the part which is located inside our room giving cold air. So when the low pressure mixture of liquid and plus vapor refrigerant enters to the evaporator, it takes the heat of the surrounding and it takes the heat from the air which is passing through these coils, heat exchanger, and it converts into low pressure vapor. How it happen we can explain. When this low pressure liquid plus vapor enters in the evaporator, normally the refrigerant which we are using commonly, we can say this R22, the boiling point for this R22 is minus 40 degree. So whenever we use, our application is not teaching this one. Suppose in room we need the cold air temperature 17. So when this the air of a higher temperature than 40 degree will come in the contact to the surface in the coil where this refrigerant is flowing, it will give its heat to the refrigerant and will cool down, flow inside the room as the cold air, and this refrigerant will convert to the vapor. If we are using, nowadays we are using more common refrigerant R410A. Its boiling temperature is minus 48 degree around, so it is also very low temperature. So when the air will come in the contact of the coil in which this refrigerant is passing, it will take the heat from the air and will convert to the vapor, and the air will give heat to the refrigerant and will become more cooler, and it will pass inside the room as a cold air. So in this way you will get the cold air inside the room, and this low pressure vapor, again it will go to the suction of the compressor, and again next cycle will start. So this cycle is working continuously, resulting giving us the result of the cold air and we need. So it is the basic cycle or basic principle on which the air conditioning and refrigeration system is based, and it is the heart of this system. Thank you very much.